simply because she has a point of view, or Kavita Krishnan is?
Indira Jaisingh saying that if...
Arnav?
No, no, Indira Jaisingh has said that why the judge hasn't spoken about the conspiracy theory.
Yes.
Why should the judge be made to speak at this time? That she, means that if he doesn't speak, therefore he's guilty.
No, she's not making that assumption.
We are going to reverse the values of the constitution.
No, she's not making that assumption. KTS Tulsi. Yes, Ms. Jaisingh.
I would like to respond.
Please do.
Please
do.
Yeah. I think Mr. Tulsi needs to understand that no FIR has been registered till date.
Yes.
As he says, the presumption of innocence is available to an accused. At the present moment, the judge is not an accused person. The question of presumption doesn't come into the picture at all. Secondly, we are talking here about a person who's occupying a position of trust. The office of a judge, the office of chairperson of the Human Rights Commission, no one holds that office as of right. They hold it only on the condition of good behavior. The moment their behavior is called into question, even if it's just on the basis of a suspicion, they are required to step down in the interest of the institution. We are not talking here about the interest of Justice Ganguly. We are talking here about the institutional morality of institutions like the West Bengal Human Rights Commission and indeed of the Supreme Court itself. So we need to be very clear who we are referring to. We are referring to a judge, and a judge holds office on trust.
Okay, so here, sir,
if there's the slightest suspicion,
Arnab, can I be heard?
The rule of presumption of innocence does not apply to a judge who holds an office of trust.
No, I get your point. And to reiterate that, just one addition before I go to Sanjay
After
Hegde.
Accusing you say doesn't apply.
No. KTS Tulsi, it's a quasi-judicial position, the body he holds.
There's no FIR. Arnab, please make it clear to him, no FIR has been filed.
Arnab, we are treading such dangerous ground. We are laying down precedents that even before an FIR is lodged, you must resign. For 8 months, the girl doesn't...
No, I don't think so. No. One minute. No, you are wrong.
What kind of jurisprudence we
no,
are...
No, no.
We are reversing all...
No,
We are creating dangerous...
No, no, we are not. We are saying that one particular individual, Sanjay Hegde, I'm coming to you next. There is a Supreme Court committee which is looking into the allegations against Justice Ganguly. He's not stepped down, but you know...
We are not willing to wait for the report.
No, but you know that...
We are not willing for the...
Of course
we...
Of course we are, but you see, he can only be removed by a process initiated by the President of India under Section 23 of the Protection of Human Rights Act of 1993. I don't want to preempt that.
We want to preempt the report.
I am not preempting that, but you know that the process of removal, the technical process of removal is wrong and requires the Supreme Court to hold an inquiry. So Justice Ganguly is already, therefore it can be argued the beneficiary. He is the beneficiary of a long rope, and hence the onus is on him. On how
we
he wants to react to
illegal pressure on him.
Illegal pressure. Okay, you're saying Indira Jaisingh puts illegal pressure. One second. Sanjay Hegde.
Yes.
Illegal pressure are your words.
There is a very important principle here. Arnab, if I may butt in. There's one more important principle here. And the important principle here is that even a judge is entitled to justice. Even a judge is entitled to due process. Please look at the kind of precedent that would be set if Justice Ganguly at this stage of an accusation were to step down. That would then set a precedent that the next judge who gives an inconvenient judgment or any kind of finding, he can very easily be made to step down the next day by having somebody file a complaint or an accusation. That would be very dangerous.
No.
Therefore, Justice Ganguly is right, at least in this, by saying
Sanjay Hegde,
the time has not come.
Sanjay Hegde,
Justice Ganguly may decide just a minute. Justice Ganguly may decide to the contrary after the committee submits his report.
But
today is not the stage.
Indira Jaisingh, rebutting you.
Today is not the stage.
Indira Jaisingh, rebutting you.
Yes. Yeah. Look. Look at the responsible way in which the intern has behaved. She did not put his name in the public domain.
Oh, yes.
Secondly, when called upon to depose before the committee, she deposed. Thirdly, when asked to produce her witnesses, she produced them. Fourthly, it was the Supreme Court of India that made his name public. How much more responsible do you expect an intern to be? Now, please take it from me. If the Supreme Court of India chooses to make his name public, they have to have good reason to do so. If they had come to the conclusion
the
that there was
good
no merit
was
in complaint,
to eliminate
please
the names
me,
of the other judges. There was
me,
suspicion about
why,
the other judges.
Why would they
and
make
that
the name public?
What suspicion of the other judges? What do you mean by suspicion
why
of the other judges?
The
what about the suspicion which,
because
with respect...
Because the blog was ambiguous.
No.
A recently retired Supreme Court judge.
What about...
It was not certain
what about,
he had recently
and I think,
retired.
I think the time has
the
come to be direct tonight.
The incident.
No, one second, Mr. Hegde.
Four other judges of
no,
very
Hegde.
High character were maligned during this entire process.
Mr. Hegde.
Absolutely necessary
Mr. Hegde. Mr. Hegde, 1 minute. Let me say this. That character, prestige, honor, and integrity are not the sole prerogative or the sole right or preserve of only judges or only politicians or only those holding right office. Let me say this, that character and integrity and high principles and resolve are equally perhaps the right or the preserve of the young people of this country. And I feel, therefore, if you're talking of double standards, well, let me ask KTS Tulsi tonight.
And this lady,
KTS Tulsi,
the intern has shown the highest of character.
No.
By writing about it,
KTS
by deliberately
Tulsi,
not naming the
KTS
judge,
Tulsi.
And having come and assisted the Supreme Court committee in its investigation.
One second.
I have nothing against her.
One second. KTS Tulsi, I have a question for you.
Please note this.
KTS Tulsi, and I KTS
yes.
Tulsi, please. Now please tell me this really. And Kavita Krishnan will respond to you. You tell me clearly, have you or have you not? Have you or have you not attempted to question the motives and raise suspicion about this brave young girl you have not even heard my question. How can you deny it? Who has come out and have you said or not? Have you said or not that those you need to report these kind of cases in 24 hours? And if you take time beyond 24 hours or a few weeks, that therefore it raises questions about your motives. Yes. Have you said something to this effect?
No. I say that the law laid down even in 2013 in the case of Kanhaiya Lal is that the delay in lodging the FIR even by 60 hours detracts from the reliability of the accusation. Now this has been the age-old principle.
What?
This principle has evolved over centuries. We can't just reverse it because the judge is in the dock. The judge is also entitled. A judge is also entitled to the same protections which are afforded by the Constitution to every other citizen. Why are we denying him the right of a fair trial?
Why are you throwing indignity in the path of this victim by saying that because she didn't report in the first 60 minutes? You expect
I
KTS...
the law provides
because
for
that's
it.
The law.
Even
what the 2013
law? That's the law.
Says that you
that's
must
the law.
Lodge
delay
your complaint
in lodging an FIR
excellent.
From the reliability of the accusation.
You do not lodge your complaint within 3 months. You must explain why.
You believe you.
That's the law passed by the government of.
Can I? You believe?
Been an advisor.
You believe in Justice Verma? I am sure that at least both of you who are jumping on me tonight, KTS Tulsi and Mr. Sanjay Hegde, will have like me, and I've had the good fortune of interacting with a great man, like many of you have. I'm sure you will not disagree with Justice Verma.
Yes, of course I've had.
You do. So then let me quote what Justice Verma said. Interesting context. And by the way, I see Kavita Krishnan and KTS and Indira Jaisingh both completely disagree. Disagree with your definition of when a woman goes a little late, then you'd question her motives. Many other women will tonight. But let me read out. Okay, you want to respond to that first? Go ahead. Kavita Krishnan responding to you. What's it? Kavita Krishnan.
I want to put two things briefly here on the table.
Yeah.
Of course, delay has to be explained properly, but I think that even if you read, if you have to understand what the nature of any kind of delay in such matters is. Okay, even in the bail order that has, on Tejpal's bail petition, there is a mention of how delay should be viewed in such matters. Okay, and I think that seeing from the point of view of the complainant, she has spoken so honestly about the dilemmas that she has faced, and about, as somebody in the profession of law, a student, all right, to imagine that she will imperil her future career. Now she is working for an NGO. Now she feels I'm not in that profession. I don't have to interact necessarily. My career may not depend on this or that judge. I now feel I can maybe start talking about it.
Yeah.
When you are somebody in the same profession, it is very difficult, especially given the fact that there's so much built-in impunity there for judges. There was no Vishakha committee. Even the Vishakha committee now keeps judges outside its ambit. How are women who face this? Assume that.
Are you in any way?
What she's saying is.
Are you in any way? I want a disclosure. Are you in any way, KTS Tulsi, involved in the Tejpal defense?
Yes.
Are you, Mr. Tulsi, involved in the Tejpal defense? I want a disclosure.
I appeared as a lawyer for Tejpal, yes.
So you use that argument for Tejpal and using the same argument in the context of Ganguly?
Arnab, Tejpal is a different case.
I am only asking for disclosure.
I was his lawyer. So
what? Facts are different.
That's all right. I'm not alleging anything. I am not alleging. I'm asking. You are saying I don't have a right to ask? I am asking, Mr. Tulsi.
No. But what is this disclosure?
I am asking you
whether
you have used a similar argument in the Tejpal case. What's wrong with the question?
I have used this argument in many cases.
That's what I'm asking you.
How does that matter?
I'm not drawing a link. I'm only asking you a question.
No, I'd like to make a finish.
Anyway, you are asking a loaded question. Doesn't matter. It's a public knowledge I appeared for him as a lawyer in the High Court.
You're saying therefore.
The question really is what disturbs me. Disturbs me most about this statement of this intern is that she says 3-4 other girls have also told me.
Yeah.
And 4 girls have told me about 4 other judges.
Yeah.
She has put the entire Supreme Court in the dock.
Are you picking up cudgels on behalf of the entire Supreme Court?
Can I say, you're putting her in the dock.
You're trying to put her in the dock.
It shows lack of responsibility.
In every workplace this happens. Why should the judiciary be any very different? It's very likely that it does happen. For her to even say this, you are raising an accusing finger at her. No wonder she is delayed. Mr. Tulsi, because she fears coming up face to face with somebody like somebody against you. The difference that is being made with the Tejpal case, see, the impression which the public is getting is that where there is no CCTV footage and no apology, written apology, sexual harassment complaints are, they are bound to result in no convictions. That is not the case. There are several judgments to say very clearly that corroboration is not necessarily required if the statement given by the complainant is largely holding together, largely credible. Minor discrepancies will not be taken into account.
Let's get one thing clear. The girl has not yet filed a complaint.
Oh, please don't look at it.
She is free to file an FIR at any point of time. Nobody has held her back.
That's a technicality.
That's not a technicality. She can choose to press charges or not to press charges.
That's a technicality.
If she makes a feminist choice not to press charges, then all
that's
of us
fine.
Should respect
I will
it.
Respect
what do you mean feminist
I'll
choice?
No, just
what do you mean feminist
just
choice? What's feminist about such a choice?
Just let me quote
choose your words carefully.
I want to ask of you one thing alone. When dealing with sexual violence, can we allow ourselves to embrace feelings beyond or besides anger?
Yes, yes.
And to accept the complexity of emotions that we face when we deal with any traumatic
incident. Let Kavita respond to you.
The way I read this blog is that she thinks that it is not necessary in each case to file an FIR.
I'm not asking for it to be escalated into a criminal complaint. But I'm saying that here.
Please respect her choice.
If you're
that is what I'm saying.
Can I get in here?
Yeah, go
if
ahead.
If what Mr. Hegde is saying, respect her choice, I'm saying also respect her words then. And then we the people, one is not asking for her, one is not demanding that she must go out and file an FIR, nothing like that. But I'm saying it's a matter of a proprietorial post. You cannot be a human rights chairperson, human rights commission chairperson, if you are believing that her words, if her choice, if her words about her choice are believable, then her complaint is also believable and credible.
Well, in the case of, in the case of the victim of...
And if you respect that, then we the people cannot allow
in the case, allow me 1 minute. In the case,
question
to the viewers tonight is just one factual point and one assertion after that. Factual point at this stage is that in the case of Tarun Tejpal's victim, she too had not alleged rape. Arun Jaitley wrote rape. Kavita Krishnan said rape. They said the new law post the Nirbhaya case constitutes rape. Similarly, Mr. Hegde and KTS Tulsi, you should know that if she's alleging sexual assault, as she's claiming in her blog, allow me to complete, it may fall within the purview.
The new law does not apply to